Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about how we can deploy any package. So go to on SSDT, and here as we can see we have a project with the name of package deployment. So we want to deploy all the packages which is available inside this directory. So here we have two packages. First is flat file to database and second is database to flat file. So in our first package, let me concentrate on this, and here we have flat file source and OLADB destination. So we want to load data from flat file to OLADB destination. So before going to deploy the package, go to on SSMS and do couple of things. So go to on SSMS, and here as you can see we have integration service catalogs. So initially we don't have anything, so we need to create integration service catalog. So right click on this and then create a new catalog. So once we will create a catalog, so all the packages which we will deploy will be stored inside this catalog. So here we need to enable our CLR, then enable automatic execution of integration service store procedure at SQL Server setup. So here as you can see we have SSISDB which is our catalog name, and once we will click on OK, then it will automatically create a database with the name of SSISDB. So here we can specify a password. So I gonna specify a password, and then we can click on OK. So as we can see we are having SSISDB which is our catalog. Go to on databases, and inside this database let me refresh this, then we can see we are having SSISDB, and inside this SSISDB we have couple of tables and we don't need to touch those tables. So here we can create any folder, and inside that folder we can specify our packages which will be deployed. So here I gonna specify folder name with the demo, then click on OK. As you can see folder is created, and inside this folder we are having projects, and inside this project at yet we don't have anything. Once our package will be deployed, then those packages will be placed inside this projects, and then environment we don't have anything. We will discuss about environments in our next video. So go to on SSDT to deploy the package. Simply right click on this package deployment, then deploy our package. Now we can click on next. Here we need to specify our destination server name, so we can browse. So this is our destination server name, so click on OK. Go to on path. So as we can see we are having demo folder, so I wanna deploy the package inside this demo folder. Now click on OK, then go to on next. Simply click on deploy. It is going to loading project, then connecting to destination server, then changing protection level, and then deploying the package. So we have done. Now click on close. So we have done. Now go to on file. So this is our file, we can open. So here we are having 5 records. Go to on SSMS. In this table we are having only 30 records. So once our package will be executed, then 5 records should be inserted in this table. So let me refresh this demo folder. Go to on projects, we are having this package deployment. Now we can expand. Go to on packages. So here we are having all the packages which is available on the SSDT. So I need to concentrate on flat file to database. Now simply right click on this, and we can execute directly over here. Now we can click on execute. So it will open execute package window. Now we can simply click on OK. So would you like to open overview report? So I can click on yes, I want to see the report. So as we can see our package executed successfully, and here we are having certain informations like operator ID, package, then environment status, which is our succeed, it means package executed successfully, then the machine name. Then here we can see this is our task name and this is data flow task. So here we are having all the informations. Now we can close this report. So go to on the table. So here, as we can see, we are having 35 records. Previously it was 30 records. So in this video we have discussed how we can deploy the package and how we can run the package manually from SQL Server Management Studio. And also we have discussed how we can create integration services catalog. In our next video we will discuss how we can use the environment and how we can deploy the package if any variables are available on the package. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.